talking a little bit before about Nabba and why you decided to compete with Nabba, and you said that you've been with Nabba from the start, and that's where you're going to stay. What about Nabba, you know, yeah, attracted you to begin with, and then and what about Nabba keeps you going?
Well, originally, whenever I was getting into bodybuilding, Nabba was the Federation of Northern Ireland. That was what everybody, you know, wanted to be. The Panic was Mr. Northern Ireland. So to me, it was a no-brainer. You know, if you were Mr. Northern Ireland, to me, it was Nabba, Mr. Northern Ireland. That was the main man. It was the best bodybuilder in the country. So I started competing with Nabba for that, worked my way up through it, and just met a fantastic bunch of guys. You know, originally Ivan Dunbar, who was an amazing gentleman. You know, would say, Ivan, no matter who you were, what you were, he would have lifted the phone. If you lifted the phone to Ivan, oh, Mark, I remember, you know, he'd always a word to say, he'd always something helpful to say. I thought he was a complete gentleman. Dave Warner took over the reins again. Absolute gentleman, has done a lot for the sport in Northern Ireland. Do anything for you, as you ask. You know, through my travels and winning the Britons and then winning the Worlds, I've met a lot of great people. You know, Brian Hazel Robinson, yourself, you know, Eddie Elwood, Guy Lister, boys that I looked up to as a young boy, you know, thinking and then now I'm standing beside them on the stage, you know, and them boys giving you advice, what to do, how to do things, and I just think everybody in Nabba's got something to say, and it's always a positive word. The competitors in Nabba are always friendly, the camaraderie is always great, the venues are always brilliant, and there's just something that keeps you coming back, you know. It's like one of them things that you feel comfortable, around the people in Nabba, you feel comfortable talking to the people in Nabba, you feel comfortable with the venues, and just everybody's that willing to help. To me, it's just one of them federations that I feel actually looks after and thinks about the athletes rather than just laying in their pockets. And everybody I've spoken to this weekend has just been, you know, full of confidence, you know, offering to help you do this, offering to help you do that, you know. And to me, that just doesn't come along in any other federation. You know, to me, every other federation is just out to get one thing, and that's, you know, bums on seats and money. Where now I actually seem to care about giving something back. And that to me is, you know, as a support network as well in itself, where you can lift the phone the next year, self down, or Brian Hazel Robinson, or Eddie Elwood, or Dave Warner, and say, you know, where do I go from here? What do I do? And then actually sit down and take the time. We're all booked into the Premier League on the weekend, and every one of them we're talking to, you know, when I walked in the door, the place erupted in cheers, and that was all the head people in Nabba, you know, Brian, the whole thing. And yeah, to me, that just means that's worth its weight in gold. And why would you go anywhere else when you're getting that sort of support in your own backyard? And, you know, Paul Bernagian from the Republic, yeah, gentleman, taking the pro division, you know, they're now starting thinking, right, we need a pro division to rival things. We're taking it to the next level. Like, mm-hmm, who wouldn't want to be part of that? You know, a family-oriented thing that now there's money to be made at it and everybody doing everything for you. Mm-hmm. And as I say, the camaraderie between the athletes is first class. To me, it's a no-brainer. Where you would go, I don't think anybody that's competing in any other federations just needs their head worked up, to be honest.
It was the same when you arrived back at the hotel. It was like loving in your sitting room and your whole family.
Yeah.
Having you back in.
Well, I think I've always... one thing I've always noticed about Nabba, as I said earlier today, when people finish competing, they go out and sit in the audience and they watch the rest of the show. They don't just leave and go home. And it's something that, you know, there's a mutual respect there between the athletes, and there's a mutual respect for, you know, the show itself. It's not, people aren't just there to, you know, have a flash in the pan and nick off. And
when I won the pros, I looked around the venue and there was, I would say, 1,000 people plus. And as soon as I announced pro winner, everybody just rushed to the front of the stage and photographs. You know, people, just the press, you know, the judges, the athletes come up on the stage shaking your hand, making you feel, you know, on top of the world, basically. You know, photographs taken by a lot of the officials that wanted to, you know, take photographs of me, people that I looked up to in the past, were actually coming up, can I get a photograph taken with you? You know, can my child get a photograph taken? You don't get that anywhere else. It seems like one of the reasons I've been to the shows is cold. You know, it's like, you know, on the stage, get off, even the college, it's just cold. There's no heart in it. And to me, when everybody rushed up and you were taking time to get photographs, that to me just says it all. You know, watching your other athletes compete, them coming back out to spur you on and watch you and staying there at 11, half 11, 12 o'clock at night, it just sums it up, you know.